Hi. In this video, we will learn more about laminar and turbulent flow. Let's investigate the flow over a very thin flat plate at zero angle of attack. More in particular, we are interested in the drag of the plate. Isaac Newton already formulated an equation for the shear stress. The shear stress tau is mu times the velocity gradient. And mu is the dynamic viscosity coefficient, or in short, viscosity. So for the shear stress on the surface of a flat plate, we are looking at the velocity gradient near the wall at y is zero. Here you see the boundary layer velocity profile with the velocity u varying from zero at the surface to the undisturbed free stream velocity v at the edge of the boundary layer. Now let us define the local Reynolds number. It is defined as rho times v times x divided by mu, with x running along the flat plate starting at the leading edge. When a fluid starts to flow over the flat plate, it begins to form a laminar boundary layer. The streamlines are smooth and regular. The flow moves in neat layers. At some distance from the leading edge, the character of the flow has changed into irregular, random, and chaotic movements. This is a turbulent boundary layer. The transition process from laminar to turbulent flow is a complicated mechanism of growing disturbances in the flow, and we will talk about that later. First of all, let us look at the development of the boundary layer thickness along the plate. With his boundary layer theory, Prandtl, together with his former student Blasius, was able to simplify the Navier-Stokes equations in such a way that they could get analytical results for a laminar boundary layer. From this theory, we find that the local boundary layer thickness at a station x from the leading edge is equal to 5.2 times x divided by the square root of the local Reynolds number. So, starting at the leading edge of the plate, the boundary layer effect develops parabolically with the square root of x. Now let us look at a flat plate with length L and a width of 1 meter. At distance x from the leading edge, we have a small strip of the plate with length dx in flow direction. The total force on the entire plate is the total pressure force plus the total friction force. Since the plate is flat and very thin, and under zero pressure gradient, we have no pressure forces. The friction force on the element dx is tau times the area, which is dx times 1. The total skin friction drag on the plate is the integral from the leading edge to the trailing edge, so from x is 0 to x is L, of tau times dx. From laminar boundary layer theory, we can find that the local skin friction coefficient, defined as the shear stress over the undisturbed dynamic pressure, is equal to 0.664 divided by the square root of the local Reynolds number. So, the skin friction coefficient decreases with increasing distance from the leading edge. To calculate the entire aerodynamic force, we must integrate. So, dF, the friction force on the flat plate, is the integral from zero to the length L of CFX times Q0 times dx, since this was tau W. Okay, well, we know from CFX that it is 0.664 divided by the square root of REX. Now, together, this forms the integral from 0 to L of 0.664 times Q0 times dx divided by the square root of REX. Now, we assume that this is constant, right? So, dF is 0.664 times Q0 times the integral from 0 to L of dx divided by the square root of REX. Now, REX has a component of x. So we can write here, for this, we can write dx divided by the square root of x. But then we have to divide this by the square root of the undisturbed velocity divided by the undisturbed dynamic viscosity. All right. Now, the integral from dx divided by the square root of x is the integral from x to the power minus a half, and this is 2 square root x. Now, so we have df is 0.664 times q infinity divided by the square root of v infinity divided by the dynamic viscosity times 2 the square root of L. And this is 1.328 times Q infinity times L divided by the square root of V infinity times L divided by the dynamic viscosity. And now you may recognize here that what is under the square here is, of course, something that has to do with the Reynolds number. So it is, in fact, 1.328 times Q infinity times L divided by RE L. So the Reynolds number based on the flat plate length. Now let us define the skin friction drag coefficient. CF is a drag force divided by Q infinity times S. Now, this is DF divided by Q infinity times L times 1, because we have a width of the flat plate of 1 meter. Now, if we write CF with the result of the drag force calculation, then we get CF is 1.328 divided by the square root of RE L. So we have found that the skin friction coefficient on a flat plate is equal to 1.328 over the square root of the Reynolds number based on the flat plate length L. This equation is only valid for low speed incompressible flow, and it is reasonably accurate for high speed subsonic flow. Now, unfortunately, there is no exact solution for the turbulent boundary layer, but experiments showed that the boundary layer is much thicker than for the laminar case, and that the skin friction coefficient inversely varies with the Reynolds number to the power 0.2. So if we put the two together, we see that the friction coefficient in a turbulent flow is much higher than in a laminar flow. A turbulent flat plate will have a much higher total skin friction drag.